From time to time, we will share with you one of the more intriguing exhibits that can be found within the museums of Giza. Beyond the mountainous displays of precious jewels and finely cast golden relics, which captivate the crowds who flock to experience this extremely rich history, we personally find the more valuable of objects are often overlooked. Indeed, these precious masks and past pharaoh's possessions are undoubtedly exquisite in nature. However, there are some objects, never designed to stun or impress, but built with a function. Functions which could shed light on the most intriguing and mysterious aspects of this past civilization. The Khufu ship being but one of these said artifacts. A boat found disassembled under the Great Pyramid, once said to have floated through the sky. And although the physical idea of this ship actually flying is a leap too far for some, there is, in fact, an artifact which exists, found in 1898 during an excavation of the Padi Aymen tomb in Saqqara, Egypt, which you may find a bit more practically designed for flight through the Egyptian skies. Although numerous sources over the past century have surfaced accusing Egyptian authorities of concealing the discovery of vimanas, ancient flying machines, within the pyramids of Giza, our said artifact seems to have slipped through this net of secrecy. Often with these well-stocked and well-preserved tombs, resting places of past pharaohs, whom once possessed unimaginable riches, numerous toy models of their once favored crafts and vessels will be discovered. Exquisitely constructed miniature replicas of their favorite forms of travel. It seems this artifact may have indeed been filtered through the security netting of public paradigm. As doing so, it seems to have lost its tailplane. Known as the Saqqara bird, it is now largely thought by many to have been a replica of an ancient flying craft, more specifically, a glider. Clearly inspired by a bird's flight, the fixed wing upon its back has been found to be perfectly angled to create lift. Egyptian physician, archaeologist, parapsychologist, and dowser Khalil Messia has concluded that the ancient Egyptians developed the first aircrafts. Predictably, he has experienced considerable hostility regarding his exposé of evidences. One particular effort was undertaken by a character known as Martin Gregory, a builder and designer of free-flight gliders. He apparently built an exact replica of the Saqqara bird made of balsa wood. After testing this replica, Gregory would conclude that the Saqqara bird never flew. He told the interested parties that it was totally unstable in flight. Even after a tailplane was fitted, he claimed that the glider's performance was disappointing. He finished by concluding that the Saqqara bird was probably made as a child's toy or a weather vane. This clear attempt to suppress the truth, however, failed, and Martin has since been proven to have lied regarding the abilities of the glider. The question is, why did he lie? According to Messia's son, Dawood Khalil Messia, a successful architect who has thankfully continued the work of his father, Gregory's suggestion that the Saqqara bird was a weather vane is impossible due to the lack of markings or any holes on the model that would serve as a means of hanging it. Additionally, and most importantly, aerodynamics expert Simon Sanderson also tested a replica model in a wind tunnel without a tailplane, and found that it produced 4 times the glider's own weight and lift. In Liverpool University, Sanderson then subjected it to another, more powerful wind tunnel, this time after adding the missing tail. He stated that the Saqqara bird actually flew quite well, clearly to the annoyance of certain people who are probably now regretting not seizing the entire artifact some years ago, rather than just the tailplane. Over 2,000 years after the ancient Egyptians carved this mysterious bird, modern technology has proven beyond doubt that at full size, it could have indeed once flown through the Egyptian skies.